We begin this episode with a focus on the guys and important health information about prostate cancer screenings. Recently, a federal task force issued new guidelines on when men should have a prostate-specific antigen, or PSA test. The PSA test, which is a blood draw, is known not to be entirely accurate at detecting cancer, but experts recommend men age 55 to 69 should discuss the PSA with a doctor, especially if he has family history.
My general practitioner found out through a PSA test that my PSA score was 4.2. which I came to understand is a little bit elevated. My understanding is that 4 is kind of like the upper limit. Anything above that is reason for suspicion. And in his estimation, being that both of my brothers have dealt with this issue, that I definitely need to look into it a little further.
Typically, patients with higher Gleason scores or higher PSAs have slightly more advanced disease, so they do require some additional treatment. The Gleason score is a measure of how aggressive the prostate cancer is.
Spadaro had surgery once cancer was detected. After the procedure, specialists prescribed targeted radiation therapy.
The whole process for me here at the facility that I'm at Waterman has been very good.
Here at Waterman, we work directly with patients and other specialists to come up with the best care. We have advanced technology and we offer our patients a wide host of options. So we think that we have state-of-the-art prostate cancer here, right here in Lake County, available for our patients.
If you have a sibling, an uncle, a brother, a father that has prostate cancer, you need to be aware and you need to monitor yourself. It's uncomfortable. It's something we don't want to talk about. It's very personal, the area where the prostate is and all the things that go along with that. But you have to weigh that against the price of death.
You'll find out more about cancer diagnosis and treatment options at fhwatermancancer.com.